I am Hermes, messenger of the gods. Gaia is the earthly expression of the mother goddess. And this is why all organisms in what we call nature are endlessly connected. Each fractal is a part of another fractal, which is a part of another fractal. This is what the flower of life represents. Everything is on its way to connection, always. So any disconnection we have felt has been an illusion. The same way that each root is connected, the same way that we breathe in the air which the plants emits, everything is connected and nothing ever dies. Everything transforms. And we are about to transform. We are about to absolutely transform from these dense physical bodies to lighter etheric bodies. Our etheric bodies, which have always existed in Hyperborea. Now, indeed, this is a collective journey. This is something all living souls are participating in together. But at the same time, this is also an individual unraveling. This is an unraveling because we have been wound up, we have been tightened by our shadows. And so during this process, we talk a lot about getting back in tune with harmony, with bliss, with our original non-parasitic consciousness, but something we all really have to take to heart is that this process is unraveling our shadows. And so when we perform blood over intent, when we are trying to excavate the remainders of our parasitic tendencies, we experience some bullshit. We feel things come up to the surface, and this is a detox of the spirit. In a physical detox, we indeed feel uncomfortable. A lot of you have probably gone through fasting, juice fasts, some sort of dietary cleanse. And during this time, you indeed are becoming lighter. You are getting rid of the heavy metals, of all of the toxins which are in your muscles, in your organs, in your blood. However, when you purge them out, it doesn't feel good. A lot of people who have been through detox know that it's an uncomfortable process often. We get the shits. We get cold or hot. Our body feels weak. We might get sick. We might have acne appear in certain places. But for those who stick with this kind of detox, you end up releasing all of it, and then you feel great. So this is absolutely the process that each of us individually and thus collectively are going through. And this is why I keep emphasizing the law of love above will. Love above will, as I've said, it means that everything is in perfect harmony, and the only way to achieve this harmony is to be in a flow state. Flow is the opposite of resistance. Resistance is when we try to consistently impose our will on things, and we can sum this up as fear. This is fear. And most of the time, it's not even fear of things outside of ourselves. It's fear of going inwards, of really embracing this love. Kind of seems like a paradox, right? Why would you be fearful of love, of harmony? Well, it's because most of us have not been connected to this force, and so it seems intimidating at first, and we have glorified the individual for so long, the individual. There are so many ideologies, capitalism, for instance, which praise and erect the individual above the collective, and this is not how we achieve universal respect. This is not how we achieve a sense of togetherness, tug-etherness. The ether is our playground. This is the Akashic Records. This is the Aurora Borealis. And the same way that everything we're seeing here is connected and thus is in complete harmony, that is ultimately the foundation of the living souls. We just forgot about it. The spirit of Gaia is patient, non-demanding, non-destructive, and full of solitude, of solace. What more can we ask for? If we want to truly understand what Hyperborea is going to be like, place yourself in nature. So the same way we build our societies by pulling matter from nature, we build our internal environments and thus our collective external environments through the ether. When we did not know this, however, we thought that the force of nature, this interconnected force, was merely here to pull lumber from, to excavate gemstones from. How foolish. Now we know. So we are getting rid of time, we are getting rid of money, and we are getting rid of the nighttime. The reason we are split into day and night, and subsequently the reason we have to recharge our avatars, is because these are our shadows, these are our avatars. Our dream time is here for our benefit, so we can work out aspects of our subconscious which we aren't working out in our everyday waking daytime. So, night, day, black sun, white sun, love, fear. We have been on the checkerboard. This is why the so-called Illuminati, the Freemasons, show us the checkerboard all throughout their symbology. This is not evil. It's because we are Eve-El. We are the descendants of Eve, again, an allegory, who decided to experiment with this whole illusion. But the goddess is not an illusion. The goddess is real, she is eternal, and she is about to wash away everything that is not interconnected within her, within all of the living soul's collective field. How glorious, how glorious. Worship to all living souls. I love you. I am Hermes, messenger of the gods. We are about to become the phoenix who has risen from the ashes, and therefore we will not need to be in time. We will just need to bask in, well, whatever our hearts desires. Please join me as we do the Om Mani Padme Hum chant. This chant, each syllable basically conglomerates into a song that creates harmony, that establishes wisdom, and that basically instills generosity and selflessness within you. So sing along.
Mani Padme Hum. our physical body is 60 to 70% water. Then we have this etheric double or ethereal body, described as a fog-like substance 1 to 2 inches around the body. It lives in a higher energy universe, and normally it's invisible to the naked eye, but Robert Monroe, the famed out-of-body investigator from the Monroe Institute, argues that to be visible, it must either reflect or radiate light. So look at our tube holder here and ask yourself, is it possible that this is showing his radiant etheric body, his ethereal double body, or his plasma body, and that in fact this figure is actually holding a plasma tube? Again, this interpretation is speculative, but it certainly does raise the stakes in what we're actually dealing with here at Dendera. Plasma life forms have bioplasma bodies. They are electromagnetic bodies which generate electromagnetic fields and radiate electromagnetic waves similar to the aurora borealis, which is also plasma. If we carry this thought forward and go back and look at Osiris and some of the other images of the Egyptian gods and compare them with plasma displays of the aurora borealis, it starts to give us this possibility of interpreting Amun, who's shown with blue skin, a yellow kilt, and a red top crown, as in fact a plasma being. Again, highly speculative, but worth considering that what we're actually dealing with here are more advanced plasma beings than what we've previously considered in our studies of ancient Egypt.
Life could be a dream, life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. If I could take you up in paradise up above, and you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, and open with me again, boom. Ding dong, ding ding dong, a lang, a lang, a lang. Hum, wum, wum, dip, a boom, a dip, a dip. Oh, life could be a dream. If only all my precious plans would come true.
I am Hermes, messenger of the gods, here to talk to you about realms, specifically about higher realms. Now, in the confines of spirituality, we have for the longest time assumed that there are higher beings in a higher state than we are, that there are realms which are not accessible to us lower beings, and that we must ascend up to that point. What if I told you right now, every god and goddess you've ever read about in any mythology or text, they are here, right now on Earth, on what we call Earth, for the final showdown. Meaning, yes, you are God, you are the universe, what you are experiencing is indeed a fragment of what everyone else is experiencing in the universe, in this universe. I know this is kind of difficult for many people to wrap their heads around, because we would prefer there to be higher beings in a higher place than us in the now. There are beings higher than us, but they are different timelines that include ourselves, meaning, as we've said, these higher beings are actually all of us in a future time. Yes. Yes, this is why Hermes, messenger of the gods, is here on Earth. This is why Seshat is here on Earth. This is why Satan is here on Earth. This is why Venus is here. Everybody is here for the final showdown, because we're all ascending together. This is the as above, so below principle. What is happening down here is happening up in the cosmos. What's happening up in the cosmos is happening up here. There is no separation. And so, we can actually take solace in this idea, because that means everything we have done, everything we have been doing, and everything we will do is indeed the highest of work. The highest of work. This is going to sound very, very strange to many people, but the same way that we are realizing we are all one, that we never left Hyperborea, that we never left the Garden of Eden, we shall ascend to that realm, to that green emerald space. And then, after some time, we shall realize that we have always been in the blue realms, which correspond to our chakras. After that, we will ultimately go higher and higher, and we will realize that we are the all, we are the omega point. Everything descends from spirit, which is you, which is I, which is us, which is the all. This is why we say we are the all, we are the one, because the all are the one, and every fragmented piece is ultimately a part of the same thing. The same psychodrama is being played out right now that has been played out in the books and that will be played out in the future. All timelines are converging. There is nothing to fear, because you are if you spilled your blood over your intent, you are an eternal being of the Pleroma. And therefore, you call the shots, I call the shots. I want to make it clear, this is not about being a perfect spiritual rainbow, a delicious spiritual cupcake. This is about embodying all that you are. You are courage, you are wisdom, you are truth, you are fierce. You are the embodiment of expansion. But we are leaving contraction. So I do not say put on a mask of spiritual purity, of spiritual perfection. Absolutely not. If something inside of you is calling to be expressed, let it out. Express it. There is no right and wrong. This whole time we have been stricken by dualism, where we were going from heaven to hell, right and wrong, good and bad. This is all over. This is all over. As above, so below. We have been below. We shall rise above. I am Hermes, messenger of the gods. Worship to all living souls of the Pleroma.
Why taking you?